Sorry.
Okay, I just left Isla Mujeres this morning, right behind, and I'm heading to the western tip of Cuba. So I'm crossing the Gulf. It's about 110 nautical miles. And I should be there in 14 hours. I'm doing 7.2 knots. So it's really nice. There's no wave. I'm lucky. It's a perfect day for the crossing. I've been waiting for this day, for this opportunity to cross for almost a month. So doing 8.5, 8.3 knots. I'm past halfway between Isla Mujeres and Cuba. So this is just the beginning of the night. I should arrive close to Los Moros around 2 a.m. or even before that. My way to Dry Tortugas, and behind is Cuba. All the back there, you don't see it anymore, but they have, yeah, I can see the mountains there. I don't know if you can see for now. Calm seas. Last night was a little bit different, so I was in the middle of the Gulf between Cuba and here, and everything was going well. I had reefed twice because the wind was really picking up. There were wind gusts at 18 knots, which is a little bit much. Twice, I took down the mainsail twice because I wanted to slow down the boat. I even had to roll the Genoa in front to make it smaller to reduce the speed. The amount of sail reduced, I was doing 9, 10, 11 knots. So the boat was really moving around and bouncing and banging. But anyway, things were under control. But I could know that the rigging was working hard. And then I hear a loud bang, and then the boat just starts veering off its direction, and then the sail starts flapping in the wind, and then the tiller is just banging. The autopilot pin, you know, just completely, I don't know if you see it, but it just broke. Fatigue stress, it just busted off. Luckily, I made myself some spares, which is this guy. I can just hook it up. It's just a screw, just a bolt, and then I can hook up the pin. They're very easy. So I was able to do that in just a few minutes and get back on the way. So this is totally sailing. Everything is fine, and then suddenly something goes wrong. And if you're not prepared, if you don't have your backup, your tools. So here I have all my tools. I have spare parts. I have so much in this boat. It's a bit too much. But you know, what happened last night's like, wow, I'm glad I had that. Number one cause of ship sinking, fire on board. This is the Corsair F27. It's 1991. and it's hole number 224 and 27 feet long, and it's a trimaran. This is inside. We got a little galley here. We got food storage. This here is where I sleep when I'm on the sail. This is clothes. This is all sailing, rigging, lines, hardware. You got storage with clothing, and then you got down there my two tool bags. Very important. I got a cooler, but there's no ice in it. I just get food that can stay good for a long time. And in the back here, I'm not gonna show, but there's a little cabin, and then you can sleep two people very close by, and it's almost too small for two. I was going for dry tortugas. I would have preferred Key West, but the wind didn't let me go there. But now, during the night, it shifted, and then boom, it was perfect. So I've been sailing towards Key West for, I don't know, 10-15 hours now. I sailed from Sarasota to Key West to Havana, Cuba. Then I spent 10 days there. I climbed Pico Torquino, which is the highest peak. It's, I think, 6,000 feet, 2,000 meters. Then I sailed the northwest coast of Cuba till the tip, and then I crossed the Gulf again to Isla Mujeres in Mexico. And I went to climb Pico Orizaba, which is the highest peak of Mexico. It's 18,006 feet or 5,500 meters, something like that. It's a volcano. Climbing Orizaba was hard. I mean, I went from sea level to almost 19,000 feet in 3 days, and that was, you know, I kind of pushed it. I wish I would have waited an extra day. So on the summit, I was not feeling that great. I had to come down quickly, but it was all right. Roger that. Okay. I just got intercepted by the Coast Guard to check the paperwork. I mean, they couldn't come on board, so they had me read the numbers to them, and looks like we're good to go back home.